Hello. So I needed a thing to review today because I'm doing this whole being consistent on the internet thing for a little bit. And I looked and I was like, hey, you know, what if I did a review of one of the things that was suggested to me to do a review of? And then I decided to review the suggestions instead of making a review of what the suggestions told me to review. Andrew Young says you should review the tallest slide at every park in your hometown. Rate them on a scale of 4 to 17 on each of the following three categories. If you can eat French fries and ride at the same time. Color in reference to snow cone flavors. Distance away from a usable bathroom. Average the score for each slide. Declare a winner, and then attempt to present a plaque to that slide to your city council. Well, this is, I think, like a really ambitious idea. I'd have to break it up into like individual slides, but I think it could be a good time. I could just review every slide one at a time. You need to do a review of the letter Q. I need to do a review. I need, it's of paramount importance that I review the letter Q. I have to do it. If I don't review Q, then the world will end, the universe will collapse, everything will fall apart, and Oh, wait. I was gonna do a gag where I like fell backwards on my chair, but the chair is this far from the back of my bed. It wouldn't have worked. It didn't work. I tried it. I can't reach the thing. What's the next comment? Alright, Wizard Boy 5471 sent in, nice one, Father. You should review Peter Pan. First of all, I know this person. Not getting some insane, strange weirdo calling me their father. I should review Peter Pan. That's a good one. We have Cat in Box Productions, who says I should review Wilbert the Worm, then react to the new and improved. Well reasoned, good. Okay. You know, yeah, all right. Let's review Q. Why not? Let's do a Q review. All right, so this is a Q. I'm looking at this, and all I see is, like, an O wearing a bracelet. Like, what are you trying to prove? And then the lowercase Q is even worse. It's just a G with the backwards tail. Like, what are you? Are you proud of yourself? Are you impressed with your individuality? Because you should be. U is one of the most unique letters in the entire English alphabet. And I'm not just saying that, because the word unique has a Q in it. If you have a Q, and you have a U, then it makes the Q sounds that you were taught in elementary school. It goes qua. But without the U, it's kind of like a weird K. It's a really... It's an interesting letter. It should be used more. It's an underused, interesting letter. So, bad design, incredible concept. Good out of 7. All right, that was the very first ever real and actual Void review. So, if you liked it, tell me so. If you didn't like it, then pretend that you did. In all honesty, though, if that was absolutely terrible, I don't want to waste my time doing it again, because that was really tiring, and I'm really tired. So, if it's not worth the effort, I don't want to put in the effort that it's not worth. Happy birthday. I say it gave me a 3-day bellyache!